Welcome to the Explanation Pro. Today I'm going to explain the a thriller heist movie, titled Bad Genius. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. The movie starts with Lynn enrolling in a new school. Her father wants her to study there, but Lynn does not want to because the enrollment fee and other expenses will cost a lot of money. Since Lynn is valuable to the school for being intelligent, the school's headmistress grants her a scholarship. During the picture taking for their IDs, Lynn meets Grace, her soon-to-be best friend. Unlike Lynn, Grace is not that smart but excels in other things like extracurricular activities such as acting. In one of their talks, Grace tells Lynn that, in order to participate in acting, the general average must be at least around 3. Grace tells her that she will surely fail. But upon realizing that Lynn is brilliant, Grace asks Lynn if she could tutor her. Lynn accepts this. On the examination day, Lynn realizes that the reviewer that Grace had during her tutoring is identical to the exam. Lynn also realizes that Grace does not remember anything from their reviews. Lynn decides to write the answer on an eraser, passing it to Grace by using her shoes. They almost got caught, but luckily they finish the exam without any trouble. After that, Grace invites Lynn to a pool so that they can celebrate. At the pool, Lynn meets Grace's boyfriend Pat, and unlike Lynn, Pat is rich. After learning from Grace that Lynn helped her in the exams, Pat offers Lynn a huge amount of money to cheat in other exams. Lynn is hesitant at first but agrees eventually because she and her father need the money. Lynn teaches them about hand patterns by way of piano keys. As Lynn taps the desk, each pattern of tapping will correspond to letters A, B, C, and D. All the others have to do is memorize these patterns. Unbeknownst to her father, Lynn keeps the whole thing a secret, disguising it as merely piano lessons. Here, another character is introduced. Bank is a student who, like Lynn, has a scholarship because he is poor yet wise. But unlike Lynn, Bank is honest and does not tolerate cheating. After both of them win a competition, the headmistress informs them that there is a scholarship abroad that they can avail of. However, there is only one slot, making them rivals. During an examination, Bank, not tolerant of cheating, sees his classmate looking at Lynn's paper and decides to warn her. Still, Lynn already knows this because that person is one of the people who applied to the piano lessons. Bank warns Lynn, he also warns the teacher. The teacher is not worried because the tests are separated into set A and set B to overcome this problem. Lynn finishes her paper first, which belongs to set A, while simultaneously passing the information to another set A's by desk tapping. After that, while the teacher is not looking, she takes the opportunity to answer her classmate's paper, which belongs to set B. She finishes, but it is almost over, but still, she is able to pass the answers to another set of B's. However, Lynn is caught when Bank warns the headmistress as well. At first, it seems that they will be able to get away with it, but upon closer inspection, the headmistress notices that there are formulas in Lynn's scratch paper that belong to set B questions. As a result, Lynn's father was called. The headmistress informs Lynn's father of what she had done, and, as punishment, her scholarship was revoked. Lynn retaliates by saying that it wasn't a full scholarship anyway because there are still other expenses that they have to pay. Angered by what Lynn had said, the headmistress further punishes her by banning her from applying for the scholarship abroad. By default, Bank is now the only one who can avail of the scholarship, something that he regrets because it costs Lynn's chance. After a while, Lynn is invited again to participate in cheating. However, it involves an international examination called STIC. Grace tells her that Pat's parents want her and Pat to study in Boston. Passing the STIC will prove that they are qualified to study there. Lynn initially declines the invitation because it is a hard task, but agrees when she realizes that they can take advantage of the different time zones. Lynn can take the exam in Australia, where the examinations will be conducted in an earlier time, and then pass the answers back to Thailand. Grace and Pat ask her how she will do that, and Lynn answers them by saying that there is no other way but memorization. However, she can only memorize half of the answers. At this point, Lynn tells them that she needs a similar capable mind, which in this case is Bank. But Lynn also knows that Bank will decline because of his ethics and hatred for cheating. However, on the night before Bank is supposed to take the scholarship exam, he was attacked by two men and then thrown in a landfill, which led to him not taking the exam. Learning about this, Lynn approaches Bank and offers him the job. Bank initially declines but agrees for the sake of his ailing mother. The plan is that both Lynn and Bank will fly off to Sydney, Australia, to answer the questions. During their breaks, Lynn and Bank will go to the bathroom, where they will hide their phones, to deliver their half of the answers back to Grace and Pat. Back in Thailand, Grace and Pat will print out the answers in barcodes printed on pencils, which will then be delivered to multiple clients, which in this case are the aspiring stick examinees. However, something happened on the night before they fly off to Sydney. During a mock interview about what they should say if they are caught in the act, it is revealed that Pat is the one that ordered those two men to attack and leave bank on the landfill. He realizes this immediately when Pat, interviewed by Lynn, tells Lynn that he does not know bank, that he was beaten almost to death and left on a landfill. Bank never told anyone that he was left on a landfill. Filled with rage and anger, Bank attacks Pat, who, at first, does not understand why Bank suddenly attacked him. Bank shouts at him about how he never told anyone about being left in a landfill. Pat attempts to apologize, but Bank storms off in a rage. Lynn also leaves to catch Bank. However, Bank returns after realizing that what he is doing is for his mother. Lynn asks him why, to which Bank answers that this is all her fault, that the reason he ended up in the landfill was because of her. Because of this, they continue their plan. They finally arrive in Sydney to take the exam. Both of them finish their exam before the break, leaving them with more time to memorize their answers. However, during their break, in the bathroom, Bank tells Grace and Pat to raise his share from 1 million to 2 million. Pat, reluctant at first, delivers half the money and promises that he will give the half after Bank gives the answers. Bank delivers his answers. They answer again and finish before the break, giving them time to memorize. However, they encounter a problem during their second break. The officials of the examinations have caught the attention of Bank's strange, long bathroom break. Lynn, on the other hand, ends up late because there was in queue inside the women's bathroom. Bank is caught red-handed. Lynn escapes, carrying her phone with her and hiding it on her boots and eventually on a water cooler. Lynn proceeds to answer her exam without Bank. But, because she is running out of time, she makes herself vomit and then tells the official that she is sick. She leaves early, but she has already memorized the answers. However, the officials that caught Bank also tries to catch her in order to know if they are connected. While being chased, Lynn is delivering the answers on her phone. She almost fails to deliver the last set of answers but ultimately is able to do so. The officials finally caught her, asking her to come with him for questioning. During the interrogation, Bank motions that Lynn should go and leave him, therefore sparing her from being caught. Lynn tearfully does this. Back in Thailand, Lynn is happily greeted by Grace and Pat, but Lynn turns her back on them and rejects their invitation to celebrate. Grace and Pat proceed to celebrate along with other people who had similarly passed the examinations. They message Lynn to invite and tell her that Bank took his share, but Lynn leaves the group chat. Grace and Pat, especially Grace, were devastated by this. After that, Lynn receives a message from Bank, inviting her to his house. Lynn sees that Bank's house is now renovated due to Bank's share of the money. Inside, Bank informs Lynn that there are other sets of examinations which they can cheat again. Only this time, Bank assures her that it will be much safer and that the money is much greater than last time. But Lynn declines his offer. Bank, shocked by her decision, warns her that if she declines, he will tell that Lynn is the other mastermind of the whole stick affair and that Grace, Pat, and other examinees will be implicated. Lynn declines once again, deciding that she will be the one to tell the authorities what happened. The movie ends with Lynn entering a room where a person asks her about her involvement in the suspected cheating in the stick examinations. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe my channel for more videos like this. See you in the next video.